It has long been a given that a four-year college degree is a prerequisite for moving up the economic ladder. But for some, that requirement is having unintended consequences. Paul Solman has the story for our series on Rethinking College.
So I type in, yep. C-O-N-S-T, space, port.
In Durham, North Carolina, software engineer Tony Bird is so sure of his skills, he was game to try to teach me how to code.
Space 3000.
Semicolon.
And the spaces and the format is very particular.
I love understanding systems. And that's
white hat hacker Oscar Anaya, who grew up dirt poor in a Texas border town, is pretty confident himself.
Because I've always been good at computer hacking.
In Cumberland, Maryland, the heart of Appalachian coal country,
my high school mascot was a coal miner.
Cybersecurity engineer John Hartman isn't bashful either.
There was no better candidate than me for that job.
But Hartman didn't have a college degree. Neither did Anaya or Bird. And that alone kept them out of good jobs for years. Bird, quarterback of his high school football team, let his chance for an athletic scholarship simply slip away.
I just kept procrastinating and pushing it off and didn't put in the, you know, application form like I should have.
Instead, he wound up working as a barista for 7 years. His current colleague, Mariana Perez, also now a software engineer, toiled as a manicurist for 9 years as she struggled to pay for community college.
I had to stop work, make sure I had the money, and then continue because I didn't want to have loans.
In John Hartman's second year of community college,
my car just broke down. I had an 88 Ford Bronco. The transmission went out on me twice. I can't afford to go to college. I need to go get a job.
At a local factory, building cabinets, followed by a stint as a freight train conductor, then shift work at a paper mill.
One of the most dangerous industries that there is, chemicals, moving machinery that anybody could get swept into and hurt.
Oscar Anaya also dropped out of community college and took high-risk work on an oil rig.
In the sun, with chemicals and helicopters and things like that, I was breathing in a lot of small, fine particles of granite. So it completely destroyed my nostrils and my sinuses. So I had to leave that job. I was like, you know what? I'm good with computers. I should try doing something with computers. So I applied and I applied and I applied. No one was picking me up.
Why was no one picking you up?
Something's happening that is just not letting me through. And the only criteria that I could think of is education. And I honestly started falling into a very nihilistic way of seeing the world, that where I was like, you know what, this is just how it's going to be. I'm probably never going to make as much as my friends are making because I just didn't finish college.
You mean you had good reason to believe you were being rejected because you didn't have a college degree.
Mm-hmm.
That then made you feel inadequate because you didn't have a college degree?
It contributed to my downward spiral emotionally, yes.
Anaya is far from alone, says economist Byron Auguste.
Over the last 40 years, we've come to a place where the vast majority of middle-class jobs require a bachelor's degree to be considered.
Sometimes to the point of absurdity.
Even though two-thirds of administrative assistants don't have bachelor's degrees, three-quarters of the new job postings for administrative assistants say you have to have a bachelor's degree to be considered for that job. So two-thirds of the people who currently do that job can't apply for three-quarters of the new jobs in the field.
But why?
Sometimes a company will require a college degree just because they can.
Hiring expert Nick Korkadilos, who runs the Ask the Headhunter website, says the degree hurdle emerged as help wanted ads moved online and the number of applicants per job exploded.
Sometimes a company will get 10,000 applicants for one job. How do they winnow them out? One of the easiest ways is just to require a college degree.
Well, this is obviously discriminatory against people who don't have a college degree, right?
Well, but you can't accuse a company of discriminating because they asked for a college degree, can you? You can't process people through a database. You can process their keywords through a database. And a college degree is nothing more than a keyword.
But the net effect is discriminatory. Overall, more than 60% of American workers don't have a four-year degree. But, says Byron Auguste,
when you put a bachelor's degree screen on a job, you exclude almost 70% of African Americans. You exclude almost 80% of Latino workers. And by the way, you exclude almost 70% of rural workers of all races.
And that, says Auguste, has been fueling inequality since 1980. Pushing wages for those with just a high school diploma down 13%, adjusted for inflation, while wages for those with a four-year degree have risen by 13%. For men, the difference in lifetime earnings is now around $1 million.
To say that college can be a bridge to opportunity, well, that's great. But to make college a drawbridge that pulls up, and if you can't cross it, then you have no path to opportunity.
And you wind up in the low-wage moat.
So I did a little bit of valet parking.
I finally got on with UPS as a package handler for the Christmas season.
I went into retail. I sold computers.
I'm tired of being at the mercy of all these other jobs. I want a career.
This simplistic bachelor's degree screen, it's really outlived its usefulness. So employers are leaving so much talent on the table.
Not all employers, however. IBM, for instance, has Earn While You Learn apprenticeship programs, which have trained the four people you've now met. No experience required, though Oscar Anaya, now on IBM's top hacker team, already had plenty of skills.
I've been hacking computers since I was 12 years old.
Because that was the only way he could get a computer.
We were extremely poor, so what could I afford?
An old one for $20, locked. So he had to hack his way in. And fittingly, during his apprenticeship interview,
he was asking me about how to break into things.
Like electronic ankle bracelets.
I told him that a lot of the attacks could be done with a $3 screwdriver and a couple of cables, which is something that your, you know, security tester would not imagine. And yeah, that's how I got accepted into the IBM apprenticeship.
As did Tony Bird after his 7 years behind the Starbucks counter in the IBM lobby.
When did it occur to you that you could actually work at IBM?
So that's when my friend Dave comes in.
Software engineer Dave Green, who was a regular customer.
It happened one day when he asked me, how do I go upstairs and do what you're doing? I'm like, well, you just got to learn how to talk to computers. And he asked me, can you teach me how to do that? And I said, what are you doing during lunch?
Green tutored. Bird learned the basics of coding. On his second try, he passed the apprenticeship test and immediately tripled his pay.
Are you sorry you didn't go to college?
Nope, not now.
And so a final question for philosopher and longtime professor Martha Nussbaum.
Do you think every young person in America should go to college?
Yes. Well, everyone who wants to. Going to college has three purposes. One is to prepare you for a job. A second is to prepare you for a life full of richness and meaning. And a third is to prepare you to be a good citizen.
As she argues in her book, Not for Profit, without good citizens, democracy dies. But she adds,
the first thing is everyone should have the opportunity to do it without crushing burden of cost.
That's why IBM's former software apprentices could hardly believe their ears when IBM's Kelly Jordan told them.
We've been partnering with the American Council on Education, and they've actually determined that the Software Development Apprenticeship Program is worth up to 45 college credits, which is the equivalent of 3 semesters of college.
Wow.
Based on the completion of the IBM
apprenticeship.
Huge.
Putting Tony Bird close to an associate's degree.
Wow, that's great. That's impressive. That's good news.
That's a great news. Thank you.
And Mariana Perez, close to her bachelor's, though she no longer needs one to get a high-paying job. For the PBS NewsHour, Paul Solman.